I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence.
From the Tour Nation Productions studio, here is anchor Isaiah Courtney.
Reporting from the worldwide headquarters of Tour Nation Productions, located at Ball High School in Galveston, Texas, welcome to the award-winning Good Morning Ball High. I'm Isaiah Courtney. Attention all students. End of course star testing will be held on April 9th and April 11th. English 1 on Tuesday and English 2 on Thursday. If you are required to take one or both of exams, please be sure and arrive to school on time both dates. Attention all seniors. In order to take advantage of the special sign-in and sign-out opportunities next Tuesday and Thursday, you must be in good standing with your attendance, makeup hours, and credit recovery. For further information, please see your AP. Attention, all Spanish Honor Society members will be having a meeting on Tuesday, April 9th at 7:45 a.m. or at 3:45 p.m. Please make plans to attend in room 1025. And don't forget to wear a student ID while being in dress code each and every day. On today's national calendar, it's National School Librarian Day. Now let's check in with Roy and see what's trending on social media.
Thanks, Isaiah, and here's what's trending today on social media. Uncompatible hair syndrome is real. The trailer for the new Joker movie starring Joaquin Phoenix is out. And Pet Sematary returns to theaters. Back to you, Isaiah.
Thanks, Rory. Here's today's Fitness Minute with Annette Hammond.
It's the Fitness Minute with fitness expert Annette Hammond.
Many people have misconceptions about strength training. Some think that lifting weights is only for young athletes and professional bodybuilders. But the truth is, strength training can benefit everyone, from the very young to the elderly. Harvard Medical School reports that studies indicate that strength training, as well as aerobic exercise, can help you manage and sometimes prevent conditions as varied as heart disease, diabetes, arthritis, and osteoporosis. They cite that chief among its health benefits is its ability to protect vitality and make everyday duties more manageable. As we age, muscle tissue, bone density, and strength decline. So too does muscle power. So to keep your muscles and bones strong, incorporate strength training into your workout. I'm Annette Hammond. Like us on Facebook at Fitness Minute with Annette Hammond.
Here's today's Words You've Never Heard segment.
It's words you've never heard.
Are you superstitious? I'm not, because I believe it's bad luck to be superstitious. Some people believe that certain numbers are unlucky, and most cultures have superstitions centered around the number 13. The word paraskevodecatriophobia was coined by therapist Dr. Donald Dossey. He claimed that if you can pronounce this word, then you will be cured of the dreaded Friday the 13th affliction. Irish brides wear small bells on their wedding dresses as a symbol of good luck. The ringing allegedly discourages evil spirits intent on destroying the marriage. What's the word the Irish use for a lucky person? A poxajammy. I asked my husband if he believed that getting married on a Friday was bad luck. He said, of course. Why would Friday be different than any other day?
It's words you never heard.
I'm Carolyn Davidson, and you can have fun challenging your words you never heard vocabulary with my free app, Too Funny for Words.
Now stay tuned for today's Time Rewind, courtesy of our good friend Dave Mendel.
It's Time Rewind for April 4th. The year is 1968.
Dr. Martin Luther King, the apostle of nonviolence in the civil rights movement, has been shot to death in Memphis, Tennessee.
CBS Evening News anchor Walter Cronkite. As word of the assassination spreads, riots erupt around the country, and the National Guard is deployed in Memphis and Washington, D.C. President Lyndon Johnson appeals for calm.
I ask every citizen to reject the blind violence that has struck Dr. King, who lived by nonviolence.
Forget about a British invasion. In 1964, it's an all-out takeover as the Beatles have a lock on the top five singles in the U.S., What's number one, you ask? Never before and not since has a single act achieved that kind of musical monopoly. That's Time Rewind. I'm David Mendel.
In addition to the website, Time Rewind can also be found on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Check it out for even more pop culture and trivia. I'm Isaiah, and have a terrific day.